Tell up, love everybody. Poetic, Basic, Say Five, Just Renzo in the house. Footable Radio. We got a special guest in the building. It's the brother all the way from West Side, Okilangi, Aotearoa. My what's up on the 828 spot of town.
Yeah.
Light Side, spelt with three eyes.
Three eyes.
Three eyes. Is that the third eye?
Yes.
You got to read into it like that, ladies and gentlemen. Give a warm round of applause in your bedrooms for Mellow Downs.
Hey. What up, cousin? What up, cousin?
What up, cousin?
How are you?
Man, I'm sober-ish. Still.
I'll ask you that in half an hour.
Yeah, bro. Let's run it.
Yo.
Man, long time coming, bro. Thanks for coming through.
Man, anytime or so. Anytime.
Yeah, like, what's good, man? Pacific Music Awards. Let's get into that, because I know Jazz wants us to do that straight away.
Yeah.
Right,
yeah.
Those ones. Shout out to New Zealand on Air.
And I got my nomination dropped off to me. Straight to the door. I didn't even have to leave the house.
Oh, wow.
Shout out to Jazz. To me, like, I love the awards and stuff, but to me, the validation is us, like,
yeah,
just like the communication that we have through all the artists getting together, unifying each other, and just like the community, yeah, that's the real reward, I reckon. Award, I should say, yeah.
Yeah, that's real, bro. I feel like everything's good right now in the culture, too.
Hard
Everyone's
out.
Moving, elevating. You're doing really good, bro. Like, you're the one. You're up, bro.
I appreciate it.
And it's a beautiful thing to see the consistency, the professionalism that you're running with, bro. Like, there's levels to this shit, right?
Yo.
And you up, bro. And you taking everyone with you. And I really appreciate how you carry yourself. You
always been a real one. I appreciate that. Eh? Just always trying to do things that, like, I think people would buzz out on. Like, why is he doing that for? Or, like, I like getting reactions out of people, like, especially with the Cabo Corner thing and, like, the hot sauce and my own socks kind of thing.
Yeah.
Kind of like the same template that you use as well. Like, people are like, man, I see him at the markets every week, you know? Like, people buzz out on that kind of stuff. And I think that's, for us as parlies and as artists, is like groundbreaking kind of stuff. Like, people don't really, not your average person does that kind of thing. And I think it's like important, especially for these young ones that are like, oh man, I want to go and sell my hats or glasses or whatever at the markets, but I ain't got the confidence. And then seeing someone like yourself do it every weekend, it's just like, oh, if that guy can do it, then I can do it too. So just doing something like outside the box, yeah, that's kind of my vibe these days.
You know, the first time I seen you, bro, before I knew who you were,
yo,
was in Brisbane. Brisbane, Australia, yo. And I woke up in the morning after a big ass party. Like, it was one of those days. And Kenzie and Cole were playing you on the big screen in the lounge.
Oh,
and I seen, and I was like, Mellow Downs, that's like the coolest name I ever heard, bro. And then we flew over and we met for the first time properly down at Rep FM, huh?
That's right. And I was having a cover with Prestige in that.
Yeah, and then we started freestyling in the back. I remember that.
Yeah.
And that was before I found out we were related.
So that was dope. That was dope.
Yeah, for those listening, I found out that we have the same great grandfather on the Hunt side.
Yeah.
So John Hunt is our ancestor.
And he's a Palangi.
Yeah, he's a good Palangi, man. People, I just want to put that out
there. Not many people know it. Like, the Hunt name comes from a white man.
Yeah, bro. And he was the first British man to live in Samoa.
Yeah, and he had, nine wives. And then that's how we spread the name, because, like, those nine wives had different kids, and then boom.
Yeah, and so if you're a Hunt listening, you're our cousin. You know, any Samoan that's a Hunt, it's all one family.
Yeah, and then there's the Parkers, of course.
Yeah, it's all the same line.
And then the Stowers, we're all related.
Yeah, the same line, bro. Shout out all the cousins, Stowers Powers. Yeah.
Stowers Powers.
Bro, congrats on that. Congrats on that million views, bro. On that. Color Studios?
Yeah.
Is that how you call it?
Yeah.
That was in Europe, huh?
Yeah, it only took 3 years, but we made it.
Bro, but honestly, can you go into that? Can you talk about being in Europe? Because you were on tour, right? Your own tour independently?
Back when I first dropped Avant Tales, I was talking to Noah Slee. Shout out Noah Slee. Tongan living in Berlin. And I was just like, man, I want to, because he was doing big things over there at the time. Oh, he still is, but like, I was like, well, this dude's an islander and he's like cracking it in Europe. And I was like, man, I want to go over there and do something. Like, and so I hit him up. I was like, bro, can you set up some shows? If I come over, I'll pay my own way. And then I hit him up about Colors, because he actually did a Colors. And I was like, bro, do you reckon you can hit them up and see if they're keen? And so when I got there, they were like, oh, Mello's here, we'll hit him up. And so they got at the bar. I was like, oh, is he keen to do Colors? And we were drinking, hey, we were just at the we were at a bar just drinking, and then he got the call and they're like, oh, do you want to come through today? And I was like, bro, what the fuck, we just on one, like. So I rocked up, and then he just gave me this like little map, like, oh, you take this train, then you take that one. Bro, it was like an hour of like just taking trains to like in the middle of nowhere. I was like, bro, I better get this right. And then got to the spot, and there was like a warehouse, and I was like, bro, this is Bazzi Colors, because I'm a big fan of Colors, because like a lot of my favorite artists go on there. So
I never knew about it until I saw you.
Yo,
that's true. You know,
yeah.
And I think maybe a lot of people in the hood too, over here, especially.
Yeah.
You know, we don't know Colors.
But that was me.
Because of you, though.
But yeah, I was just horse Bazzi, just rocked up, and then
running it.
Yeah, gave them my USB, and then I had to choose a song. Chose Son of a Queen, and then yeah, now the rest was history, which was pretty cool. And then as I was leaving, this chick pulled up and she was all flamed up, and I was like, hey, who was that? And it was Mahalia. Yeah. And
I've
I was like, man,
too.
I knew I should have hollered at her back then, eh? I knew I should have hollered at her. I was like, bro, she's always, nah, jokes. I had a girlfriend at the time, I'm just joking. But she was on, and I was like, bad. Because, like, some of those artists, you're like, oh, yeah, they're mean, but they never blow up. But she, like, after her one just blew up, and then now she's, like, big time, so.
She's away, man.
Yeah.
How did they absorb you over there as a Aotearoa MC?
Man, that's the thing about Europe is, like, the rap over there like is like loved. It's not regional. Like if you go States, Atlanta only really listen to like Atlanta. If you're on West Coast, it's only like West Coast Bay Area. It's all regional. Whereas Europe, you can be from anywhere, and if you're all goods, then they mess with you like that. And it was like I think one of my shows was on a Tuesday night, and it was packed out. And that's just like how the culture of Europe is always. There's always something happening. So like no matter who you are or like what you do, like your gig will always be pretty much packed out. Yeah. But there were heaps of like people from New Zealand that lived there that came to the gig. Like there would have been like 100 people that are from Auckland or from around New Zealand that were like, oh, we heard you were playing here, so we thought we would come. And I was like, bro, I didn't even. And like people knew some of the songs, and I was buzzing out there. Yeah, even when like in London, when people like knew like some of my songs, I was like, bro, what the hell, this is out of it. Because I was only dropping stuff on Bandcamp back then, so I was like, yeah, so it was aware.
Tuned in, bro.
Yeah, they were tuned in. They were tapped in, yeah. For real.
So with that lesson in life, you come back, you're doing all the festivals after that, huh? When you get back,
yeah,
you got the big shows, big crowds,
yo,
thousands of people in the air. And with that, do you feel like that helped you when you went to LA?
Yeah,
like just you felt more settled going there, like, okay, I'm going back overseas now. Just straight to work.
Yeah, for real.
Straight but to then Roscoe's Chicken and Waffles.
That's the one. That was like that was cool as well, but it was still another like comfort zone thing, because obviously like I had never been to LA or America before, and like I grew up on that kind of music, so like to see it firsthand and stuff was like crazy. Like getting straight into sessions with like really big producers and that, I was like having those like pinching myself, but I was like bro, what the hell. And but as soon as they know you're someone, then like, bro, the respect just goes all the way.
I was about to ask you that. Did they hit you up
like, hey, where are you from, bro? You're from New Zealand,
Samoan,
bro?
Samoan?
Yeah. And then I was like, yeah, I'm Samoan. Oh shit, you Samoan, bro? Oh, do you know, bro? Like, I was just name dropping and all that.
Yeah, Dwayne's my uncle, man. Come on now.
But nah, as soon as like they find out you're Samoan, especially like the African Americans, they're like, oh, bro, my security's I played football with. Blue. And I was like, oh, yo. Yeah, but yeah, it's pretty cool. It's pretty cool to see how Pacific Islanders have such a good reputation over there.
Yeah. A lot of hard work, trials and tribulations went through, and the Usos, the OGs, really put on for Polynesians, man.
Yeah, for real.
Shout out everybody tuning in from America right now. We love you. We miss you. You'll be there soon. Huh?
Straight up.
We going over?
Hell yeah.
Who did you work with out there?
I work with heaps of cats. I work with DJ Khalil. He does stuff with like Dr. Dre, Kendrick. He got like, I think, 3 songs on Go Kid Mad City with Kendrick.
You were running with Dreamville, huh?
Yeah. I had a meeting with Dreamville. That was buzzy as hell. Like,
that's crazy, bro.
J. Cole's business partner and their marketing director. Yeah.
Can you speak on how that came around?
So I was like, oh, actually, I was in Long Beach with Chief and them.
Yeah.
And then I got a call from my manager like, where are you? We got to come into this meeting. And then I was like, oh, yeah, I'm just in Long Beach. And then he was like, what are you doing out there? That's like an hour away. I didn't even know, like, because I was just like enjoying my, we were just drinking, and like, I didn't even know how long it takes to get to those places. And he's like, oh, I just got hit up by Dreamville. They want to meet you tonight and have a few drinks and listen to some of the demos. And I was like, whatever, like, I didn't believe him, eh? And then he just dropped me at Addy, and I picked up Baz, because Baz was like, he didn't want to come out. I don't know, I think he dropped his nuts, so he didn't want to come out those ways. He was like, drop me off, I gotta practice for my DJ set or whatever. I was like, oh, so we dropped him off. And then,
was it the weed?
I don't know what it was, there, man. I think it was after we went to the swap meet in Sloss, and he kind of got a bit like,
oh, because it's hot out there, bro. We the last time we were there was just after Nipsey.
Yeah.
The block is on, bro. It's like, yeah. And it's just in the air.
But we like pulled out to some, because I wanted to go to the where Nipsey was, the marathon store. But it was all closed off. But all the murals were still there.
Yeah.
And then when we pulled up, like all these Rolling 60s just came out of nowhere. But they were tiny. They were like, bro, they were this tall. And then they were like walking hard as. And then, you know, Chiefy just pulled up like, hey, what up? And then I was like, oh. And then that's when I looked at Baz A, and he was like, dropping his nuts.
And that's Cheap. Hey, shout out to Carter, man. Yeah. Cheap
yeah,
son.
Yeah.
Oh, man, like, my first show in LA, I was in Anaheim, actually. And it was 99 Bottles. And I didn't know what to expect. I never performed in LA before.
Was that with Sugar Free?
Yeah, opened up for Sugar Free. And you had Compton, Pomona. All the essays was everywhere, bro. And we walked in there, and it was like three Samoans that came to the show, and then three of us. And when we walked in, I was like, okay, here we go. Walk in, and then Carter's like, Jew! And
I'm
like, damn, something like that. He's like, yeah, you gotta let him know, man. You gotta let him know what's up. But everyone showed love, bro.
Yeah.
And I didn't know what they were gonna think about the music, because I know no one knows my shit out there, really. And it was all love, bro. It was all hip hop. So, all right, new album on the way.
Yo.
It's you got a name for it?
Yeah. I'm gonna call it Lone Wolf.
Okay.
Just because I don't know, like, I've always been, that's me personally, I feel like I've always been different. Like, even like in the hood and all my boys that I grew up, they always look at me like the weirdo, or like that guy's, even the moms was always like telling like all their like friends, oh, that guy's different compared to all the other also. They're like, oh, I always like did alternative stuff. Like, I was always on my own bars, and I just feel it's like, oh, I was having a talk with a friend the other day, and then they just said that, like, oh, I feel like I'm a lone wolf in this, blah, blah. And I was like, lone wolf? I was like, oh, that sounds cool. So I'm just going to roll with that, yeah.
Nah, solid, man. I like it.
Yeah.
I like it, bro. Should we drink some kava, mate?
Yes, we should.
Let's jump off the air and play some music.
Before I jump off, I just want to shout out Base FM. This was like, I think 10 years ago was the first time I came up in here. Oh, not here. Was that the one in, where was it again? Ponsonby. Oh, yeah. And that was my first time ever being on the radio, like, properly, like, and they gave me the platform to, you know, freestyle. And came, I think it was Edgar invited me onto a show. Native Tongue, sorry, yeah. And that was the first time I came on and, like, got the chance to even rap live on the radio. And it's cool to still see Base FM have that platform for us and, like, up-and-coming artists and stuff. So shout out Base FM.
Yeah.